Well, a new mystery cluster has spooked health chiefs who've backflipped on mask rules before restrictions ease at midnight. As Mark Santomartino reports, that's despite no evidence of outdoor transmission in Victoria this year.
Hours from ditching face masks outside, the rules have changed.
It's a little inconvenient, but it's an easy thing to do. We're used to it. We know that it works.
Masks will remain mandatory indoors and out across Melbourne. Health chiefs backtracking on their own advice, despite no evidence of outdoor transmission during Victoria's Black Rock, Holiday Inn, Kappa and now Delta outbreaks.
20 times less likely doesn't mean that it's zero. There is still a risk.
Professor Alan Cheng is most concerned about a new mystery cluster.
They're in a household in Reservoir. As yet, we don't know where they've acquired infection from.
Four relatives in that family home are infected. A man in his 80s developed symptoms first on Monday. He was tested on Tuesday, with his result and the rest of his family's coming back positive yesterday.
We've actually already tested several close contacts of these cases outside of the household. And they've all come back negative.
With the city in lockdown, just four Tier 2 exposure sites have been added. Marco Fine Food and Groceries in Reservoir, a BP and Bunnings in Thomastown and Coles Bundoora Square. Genomic testing isn't back yet to link the cluster to either the South Australian or Delta variant leak from Melbourne's hotel quarantine. Serology has ruled out transmission after the infected man was sent home. All staff and travellers on his hotel floor have also retested negative.
We're not coming up with a transmission path between this case in hotel quarantine and either of the families.
Lives actually depend on this. 800 people died.
Hotel quarantine and Daniel Andrews' broken back, again, hot topics on Spring Street.
It answered some of the questions.
Not all of them?
Clearly not all of them.
Unsatisfied with Ambulance Victoria's account, today police shot down Liberal questions about the morning the Premier slipped on wet steps.
You've got a tragic accident that's left a person severely injured who happens to be the Premier of the state, and that's not a matter that police will be involved in.
The fact that they are doubling down today on these nutbag conspiracy theorists is, I think, a great disappointment to the people of Victoria. You know, we are dealing with a pandemic.
A pandemic demanding vaccines and innovative solutions.
It's about locals know locals best.
Wyndham City Council opening halls for GPs to speed up local jabs.
Today we're planning to do 100 people in 2 hours with two nurses vaccinating and one doctor obtaining consent forms.
Elective surgery should resume next week despite a slump in testing numbers affected by wild weather.
We've got some tents flying around and we're doing our best to keep them open, but there are 19 sites that are currently suspended.
Professor Cheng hinting restrictions could last longer than expected.
So depending on how things go in the next week, we may need to hold at the current settings for a little longer, but obviously we'll have more to say on this as investigations proceed.
Now, Mark, some restrictions ease in a matter of hours.
Masks may be sticking around outside, Pete, but the rest of the restrictions promised to ease will do so at 11:59 tonight. The five reasons to leave your home will be scrapped. You can do so now for whatever reason with no time limit and travel up to 25 kilometres away from your home, up from the current five. Schools will reopen, as will retailers and most hospitality, albeit with some density limits. And while the weather may not necessarily inspire a 10-person picnic outdoors, the one rule still in place that you have to remember is that visits to the home are off limits at least for the next week, Pete.
Mark Santomartino.